Hello students, let us continue the story, A Shot in the Dark. In my last class, I had given you the explanation of the first paragraph. Now we can start from the second paragraph. I will read the paragraph first. Among the passengers dotted about on the platform, awaiting their respective trains, Sridharbi spotted a club acquaintance and beckoned him up to the carriage window for a chat. "Oh, you are staying with Mrs. Alfenjaga for the weekend, are you? I expect you will have a good time. She has the reputation of being an excellent hostess. She will be useful to you too. If that parliamentary project..." "Hello, you are off. Goodbye." Sridharbi waved goodbye to his friend, pulled up the window and turned his attention to the magazine lying on his lap. He had scarcely glanced at a couple of pages. However, when a smothered curse caused him to glance hastily at the only other occupant of the carriage. His travelling companion was a young man of about 22 with a dark hair, fresh complexion and the blend of smartness and desire that is typical of a rambler. He was searching furiously and ineffectually for some elusive or non-existent object. From time to time, he dug a sixpenny coin out of a waistcoat pocket and stared at it ruefully, then recommenced the futile searching operation. A cigarette case, matchbox, key, silver pencil case and railway ticket were turned out onto the seat beside him, but none of these articles seemed to afford him satisfaction. He cursed again, rather louder than before. The vigorous pantomime did not draw forth any remark from Sridharbi, who resumed his scrutiny of the magazine. So students, here Philip Sridharbi was travelling to Brill Manor to meet Mrs. Alfenjaga. By sitting inside the train, he is looking at all other passengers, those who are standing on the platform waiting for their own respective trains. Suddenly, he spotted or he noticed one of his friends, one of his club acquaintance, and he beckoned him near to him for a chat. Beckon means he is calling him using his hand. So he is calling his friend for a chat. Then they talks good about Mrs. Alfenjaga. Then when the train starts, Philip Sridharbi waved goodbye to his friend and he turned his attention to a magazine lying on his lap. There he got a companion in the carriage who introduced himself as Bertie. His name was Bertie, who was a young man of about 22 with a dark hair, fresh complexion and a blend of smartness and desire. Desire means very untidy. Then he said to Philip Sridharbi that he was the second son of Mrs. Alfenjaga. He was searching furiously for something there. And from time to time, he took a sixpenny coin out of the waistcoat pocket and stared at it ruefully. Ruefully means very sorrowfully. Then he began to search it. He was searching for that thing very frantically, but he could not find that thing. While searching, he turned out a lot of other things like a cigarette case, a matchbox, a key, a silver pencil case, like a lot of things he is taking out. But none of these things seem to afford him satisfaction. So he is cursing himself again and again, and he continued to search for the thing again. However, Bertie is too much worried about the thing that he lost. Philip Sridharbi is looking very cool. For him, this kind of activity is a pantomime only. Pantomime means an act of entertainment. He continued his examination of the magazine because these all things are not at all affecting him. Now here you can see some words with its meaning. Look at the screen. Spotted. Spotted means noticed. Beckoned. Make a gesture with hand to instruct someone to approach. Then scarcely means only just or for a short time. Then glanced. Glanced means brief or hurried look. Disarray. A state of disorganization or untidy. Now the last word, rambler. Rambler means hiker or a person who is traveling low.